Hi everyone, it's Bianca here. This week we make an old tile flower square. I use 5 different colors of yarn, and for my choice of yarn I need a 3mm crochet hook. So you need also a scissor and a needle. Let's get started. The first color, that's for me a light yellow, and we make a magic circle on the hook. And we begin with a first double crochet, that's a chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Now we in a magic circle make 11 double crochets. Yarn over, enter hook in a magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2. That's 1. 11 in total. 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. With your first chain 3 here in the beginning, we have now 12 double crochets in total in the magic circle. Now pull on that short tail of the magic circle, then the ring is closed. And now on the top of your first double crochet, that's a chain 3, in the third chain stitch, you work a slip stitch. Cut the yarn and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. New color, that's for me in white. Make a slip knot on the hook and then we start with a standing double crochet between 2 double crochets. Between the 2 stitches, not here on the top of that stitch, but between the stitches. Make 1 double crochet, a standing double crochet in that space. Yarning over, then here between the 2 double crochets, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2. For a standing double crochet. Now back in that same space, between the 2 double crochets, make 2 more double crochets. That's 1. And 2. So we have in that same space a group of 3 double crochets. Make a chain 3, 1, 2, 3. Now skip 1 double crochet and then between the next 2 double crochets in that space make also one group of 3 double crochets in that space. 1, 2, and 3. Make a chain 3, 1, 2, 3. Now skip the next 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, and then between the next 2 double crochets in that space, make a new group of 3 doubles. So 1, 2, 3, make a chain 3. Now skip 1 double crochet, and then between the next 2 double crochets, also one group of 3 doubles. It's 1, 2, and 3. Make a chain 3. Now we skip the next 2 double crochets, and then between the next 2 double crochets, a new group of 3 doubles. It's 1, 2, 3. Make a chain 3, skip 1 double crochet, and then between the next 2, a new group of 3 doubles. Make a chain 3, skip 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, between the next 2 double crochets, a new group of 3 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, chain 3, skip 1 double crochet between the next 2 double crochets and no group, our last group of 3 double crochet in that same space, chain 3, skip the next 2 doubles, and then here on the top of the first standing double crochet make a slip stitch, reach your hook, yarn over, pull through, pull through, cut the yarn and wave both tails in. Make a slip knot on the hook with a new color. For me is that a light purple. And then we start with a standing double crochet in a chain 3 space. So yarning over in that chain 3 space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull to 2, yarn over, pull for 2. Now here in that same space make 7 double crochets. The first is complete, that means that you work 6 more in that same space. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we have here with your first standing double crochet 7 double crochets all in that same space. And this is also the repeat you work all the way around. You skip the next 3 double crochets and then here in that chain 3 space make 7 double crochets all in that same space. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Work like this all the way around till you have 8 of these flower petals in total. I made all my petals. Now here in the beginning you can close on the top of the first standing double crochet with a slip stitch, but I choose for an invisible join. To make an invisible join you cut the yarn and then you open up that stitch, pull the hook all the way up, and then I grab the needle. And now we close on the top of the second double crochet, not here on the top of the first standing double crochet. You skip that stitch, you go to the next stitch, the second double crochet, and then on the top of that stitch, under to that V, front to the back, then pull through, you go back to the last double crochet, that's number 7 of that last flower petal, on the top only in the back loop of that stitch, and then pull through. This stitch here, this little V, is your invisible join. Make a little knot on the back and wave both tails in. New color, make a slip knot on the hook, and that new color is for me a light green. And we begin with 2 double crochet together, a standing 2 double crochet together in a space between 2 flower petals. Yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook in that space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull for 2. Yarn over, back in that same space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2. We work those stitches together. Yarn over and pull to 3 in 1 go. Make a chain 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we skip over the flower petal here. And then between the next 2 flower petals, you make a corner. 2 double crochet together in that space here. Yarn over, pull to 2. Yarn over. Back in that same space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, and pull through 3. Make a chain 4. And now go back in that same space with another 2 double crochet together. That's 1 and 2, yarn over, work together. And this is your first corner. Make a chain 4, skip over the next flower petal, and then between the next 2 flower petals make 2 double crochet together. That's 1, 2, yarn over, pull to 3. Chain 4, skip over the next petal, then in the next space between the 2 flower petals make 2 double crochet together. Chain 4 and 2 double crochets together in that same space for a second corner. And this is the way how you work all the way around. This is a straight side, first corner, second corner. Make a chain 4, skip over the next petal, and then 2 double crochet together into the next space. Chain 4, skip over the next petal, and then make a new corner. Work so, like this, all the way around. Here's a corner, chain 4, 2 double crochets together in the next space, chain 4, then a new corner, chain 4, and then I show you how to close here on the top of the first standing 2 double crochet together. I'm all the way around. After that last corner here, make that chain 4. Now we skip in the beginning that first stitch of the 2 double crochet together, and we close with an invisible join on the second stitch, and that's the first chain stitch of that 4 here. And I show you how it works. So we cut the yarn, open that stitch, grab the needle, skip always the first stitch, then we close with an invisible join. That's here on the top of the 2 double crochet together. We go to the next stitch, the second stitch, and that's the first stitch of that chain 4. Go not with the needle into that space, but you go under through that V of that first chain stitch. See, you go into that stitch, then pull through, back to the last stitch, the chain 4 in the fourth chain, only in the back loop, and pull through. Leave both tails in on the back of the stitches. The color white goes back on the hook with a slip stitch. And we start in a corner space here between the 2 double crochets together groups and that in that chain 4. In that space, we start with a standing double crochet, yarning over, enter your hook in that space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull to 2, yarn over, pull to 2. In that same space, make 2 more double crochets. That's 1 and 2. So we have here 3 double crochets in that space. Make a chain 2. Then go back in that same space with another group of 3 double crochet. It's 1, 2, and 3. First corner is complete. Now we skip over the next 2 double crochet together, and here in that chain 4 space make 5 double crochets all in that same space. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Skip over the next 2 double crochet together, also in that next chain 4 space, 5 double crochets in total in that same space. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And all these stitches from corner to the straight side here, we repeat those 3 more times. And I show you the next corner. Skip over the next chain 4 space between the 2 double crochet together. 3 double crochet in that space. It's 1, 2, 3. Then make a chain 2. 3 double crochets back in that same space. Work like this all the way around into the next chain 4 space, make 5 double crochets, then jump over to the next 5 chain stitches in that space, also 5 double crochets in that space, and then make a new corner. All the way around, and then we close here on the top of the second double crochet with an invisible join. The next color, that's a dark blue, make a slip knot on the hook, and then we begin with a standing single crochet in a chain 2 space here in the corner. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull through 2 from first standing single crochet. Back in that same space, another single crochet, then make a chain 2. And then back in that same space with another 2 single crochets in that same space. It's 1 and 2 to make your first corner complete. Now we skip here that first stitch here. After that chain 2 corner space, we go to the next stitch and make 1 single crochet and also a single crochet into the next stitch. Now we work here around that green 2 double crochet together, that second in the corner. You work a front post treble crochet. From treble, yarn twice over. Now go around that 2 double crochet together here, from the front to the back, around that stitch. Then here came to the other side up to the front. Now grab your yarn and pull under through that 2 double crochet together. Now you have 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. For a front post treble crochet. Now we skip the next stitch. And that's the first double crochet of the group of 5 double crochets. We skip that stitch, we go to the next stitch, make 1 single crochet in that stitch. Also in the next 3 stitches, make 1 single crochet. It's 1, 2, and 3. We work also around the next leaf here, around the 2 double crochet together. A front post treble. Yarn twice over the hook, then go around that 2 double crochet together, from the front to the back, from the back to the front, around that stitch. Grab your yarn and pull under through that stitch. Yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Now we skip the next stitch, that's the first of 5 double crochets. Go to the next stitch, 1 single crochet, also in the next stitch, 1 double single crochet, and also into the next 2 stitches, 1 single crochet. So you have 4 single crochets after that front post treble, also here, 1, 2, 3, 4 single crochets after that front post treble. Also a front post treble around the next two double crochet together. Yarn twice over, go around that stitch, grab your yarn, pull under two, and make that treble. Skip the next stitch, that's here, that first double crochet of the three in the corner. Go to the next stitch, single crochet on top, also single crochet on top of the next stitch. And this is the repeat. You work three more times all the way around. Into the next corner, two single crochets in that chain two corner space, chain two, two single crochets back in that same space. Then we skip the first stitch here after the corner and make in the next two stitches one single crochet. And then around these two double crochet together, a front post treble. After a treble, you skip the first double crochet, you go to the next double crochet and make in the next four stitches one single crochet. So we work all the way around. Work all your stitches, and then in the beginning we close with a slip stitch on the top of the first standing single crochet. On the end of this round you work a slip stitch on top of the first standing single crochet. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color. The final round with the same color, and we start with a chain two, and this counts for a first half double crochet. Now into the next stitch make one half double crochet, yarn over and yoke into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through three in one go. Now you're in that chain two corner space, we make a new corner. Two half double crochets in that space, yarn over, and to hook in the chain two space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through three. Again, yarn over, back in that same chain two corner space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two. Now make a chain two, one, two, and then back in that same space, make two more half double crochets. That's one and two for your first corner. Now we skip the first single crochet after that chain two corner space, and then you make in every stitch make one half double crochet to the next corner. So every stitch, also here on the treble, one half double crochet all the way to the next corner. So I make all my half double crochets all the way to the next corner, and then in the next chain two corner space we make a new corner. Two half double crochets, chain two, two half double crochets back in that same space. Then after that corner you skip the first single crochet, you go to the next, and then on top of every stitch make one half double crochet. Work like this all the way around, and then in the beginning we close on top of the second half double crochet. Here's the chain two, counts for a first half double crochet, we skip that stitch. We go to the next stitch on top of the real first half double crochet. This is the place where we make that last invisible join, and then we're done. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial from me. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!